It's always difficult to begin talking about something completely new. You have to be very careful where you begin, because things have to start making sense as soon as possible. Otherwise, I risk losing you, my audience, and I don't want that. So I actually thought about this for a while, and I thought that there is one thing about security that has always been a priority, probably ever since the first human being told a secret to another human being. It's all about information. And since we're all cool people with technology and cybersecurity, we're not gonna just call it information, we're gonna call it intelligence. The intelligence cycle. It's a concept, an approach. It's pretty abstract at first sight, kind of like those things that you just have to learn for an exam and then instantly forget. But its purpose is to fill the knowledge gaps and establish a well-structured set of information that you can use to make smart decisions about security. For example, to decide what firewall to buy, where to deploy it, which systems you need to patch, stuff like that. And the threat intelligence cycle helps you make these informed decisions based on your security vulnerabilities, what threats are out there, and even some historical information. And it's not just about gathering information, but also about analyzing it and then putting it to good use. So this cycle is about determining the right steps you need to take in order to defend yourself. So let's have a look at each of these phases. The first phase, planning and requirements. It's all about answering the question, why are we doing it? What is our goal? So from the very beginning, it's very important to be aligned with business requirements. Because if some security effort is not relevant to our business, then it's not going to happen. So why waste everyone's time? Also, this is where you take into consideration any legal restrictions, obligations, or regulations that might be in place, depending on where your organization is located and its field of business. Sometimes you find yourself in the position where this entire cycle happens precisely because it's mandatory by law. Then, as a high-level overview, we need to decide as much as we can at this stage what are the most likely threats that we are facing, who might do us harm, and for what reasons. What enemies do we have? Okay, this might be a bit too much, but you get the idea. And if we manage to answer a few of these questions, then we have to think about how might they do us harm. So the planning and requirements phase, it's all about having a starting point. Next comes the collection and processing phase. So before we can brag about having a great deal of security intelligence, we need some raw information, something to work with. And this is where we start gathering that information. It must be done in an organized manner. It has to be very consistent. Otherwise, you would end up with a chaos of unorganized information that nobody can make sense of and nobody wants to touch. And I really hope it's obvious that the best way to do this is not manual, and we will get into much more detail on automating intelligence during this training. For now, suffice to say that we have specialized devices out there that deal precisely with collection of information, like SIEM devices that we'll cover later. Now, of course, this information should be real, so it has to come from real devices and real endpoints from all over the place. Your laptops and mobile devices, your servers, your switches, routers, firewalls, applications, even the cloud. So another important step is the second part, processing. Information from 1,000 devices from tens of vendors must be normalized, has to be processed in a consistent format. So in order to process it all at once, information from everywhere must look pretty much the same. Well, that's normalization. When it comes to analyzing information, usually the more data you have, the higher the chances to get something useful out of it. In cybersecurity, this could mean some proof that there is a problem in your network or that an attack is currently happening. Now, unfortunately, the amount of information that you can collect from your network can quite easily become absolutely huge, overwhelming for humans. So this is where simple automated tools like scripts will help you out a lot. Now, sometimes you will have to perform some manual searches as well, especially if you try to correlate some information from different sources and you don't have a smart enough device to do it for you. Again, this is where SIEM products help tremendously. And this analysis is usually mentioned in SIEM products as event correlation or automation. Newer tools have actually gone one step further and now have some sort of machine learning engine in the backend that helps with filtering useful information from a lot of noise and with the correlation of seemingly unrelated events. Dissemination, this is actually the process of communicating your findings from that previous analysis phase. The focus should be on communicating findings internally, of course, in your own organization. And you will probably want to address these findings to multiple people at multiple levels, from the technical people that configure security devices and respond to incidents, to the upper management, even CEO level if you find some threats to the business as a whole. This dissemination phase comes with an important challenge, that is, communicating the same findings, the same ideas, to multiple audiences. A report for a security analyst will or should be very different from a report written for the CEO. Be aware that they all might have different objectives in mind. They might have a completely different set of priorities when it comes to where should we spend our money, and they kind of speak different languages. So to frame this for the exam, intelligence dissemination needs to happen at three levels. First, strategic intelligence, which addresses long-term objectives and priorities, things that we should think about, but not right now. Second is operational intelligence, focuses on day-to-day priorities of IT and security specialists, as well as their managers, so shorter-term objectives. The third one is tactical intelligence. Real-time is the shortest-term objective, and if it's some intelligence that requires us to act right now, it probably falls under the incident response procedures. You know, those tasks that have to be ready yesterday? And remember, we said the first focus is to communicate findings internally. Well, if you don't have any fires to put out right now, after we disseminate internally, we could think about doing some good deeds and helping out some other poor organization in need. This is where you have the chance to communicate those findings to other companies like yourself or to other consumers. Of course, if that intelligence is relevant to them as well. Now, nobody can really benefit if you tell the entire world, you know, we just found that our email server can be so easily hacked from the outside. Actually, that would be something that you might want to keep secret until you fix it, don't you think? Well, you might have noticed that we have a cycle here. So the purpose is to continuously improve this process. So the feedback phase is not about providing feedback to your colleagues, but about feeding new information back into this threat intelligence cycle. Things like what went right, what went wrong, any lessons we might have learned from the previous steps. Did we discover anything new since last time? Are there any new threats out there? New risks or threats that might have appeared in the meantime? Is there something new that we should be doing from now on? And you know, just before turning off the lights and calling a day, make sure you end this phase with a clear list of tasks for a clear list of people that will be responsible for making the cycle better next time. You might start from the actual findings and find out who wasn't doing what they were supposed to, but try to keep away from blaming each other and instead try to make these responsibilities as constructive as possible. Like, there is always room for improvement and we can all do better next time. Alright people, so for the exam, make sure you know and you understand all the phases of that threat intelligence cycle. You will definitely receive at least a couple of questions about which activity goes into which phase of the cycle. So review this video if you need, but make sure it makes sense for you. Don't forget to subscribe to Certified Breakfast and see you on the next video.